It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. This project scenario is based on the HipLocal case study. The question is straightforward. What should we use for log analysis? To find the context for this question, let's look at the case study itself. In the existing technical environment of HipLocal, there is no logging, no auditing, no historical analysis of systems. So that's something we need to fix. There are also just basic indicators for uptime and alerts, which tells us that there is insufficient monitoring as it is. In what is expected of us, we definitely want to improve monitoring and analysis. We also want to retain the logs for longer so that we can then perform some kind of analytics on it. Ideally, we would also like to use serverless architecture so that there is less work on the operations team and we can grow in an elastic fashion. So what are the key requirements we have then? We have to increase logging and monitoring. We have to have a way to capture logs. We have to have a way to capture metrics. We need to also retain that for a long time. And we have to be able to do analysis on that. Given these key requirements that we have fleshed out of this case study, let's look at what are the options that we have. Option A suggests that we use Cloud Spanner to store each event. But which events? Currently, there is insufficient logs being captured, and there are hardly any events at all. So what events are we actually talking about storing? Therefore, it's already looking like an incomplete solution. Even then, let's look at what Cloud Spanner could do for us. What is Cloud Spanner? It's a global transactional database. But for the kind of things that we need to have here, which is to be able to run huge analysis on large amount of data, we don't need a transactional database. Ideally, we want something that is read optimized, that is an online analytics processing engine. We also don't necessarily need the storage to be global. Chances are that our analysts are going to be in a few locations, and therefore regional storage is sufficient. With the kind of technology that Cloud Spanner provides us, it might be just overkill for the kind of situation that we have. And definitely not suitable for analysis of data also. So based on all of that, option A to use Cloud Spanner is definitely not it. How about we store key metrics in Cloud Memorystore? Well, the same thing that we started off with first, that what are these key metrics? Where are we capturing them? We haven't got them yet to store it. Even so, assuming we have that, Cloud Memorystore has a problem that it is not persistent. Also, because it is stored in memory, there is going to be less scalability with respect to storage compared to some of the other persistent stores. Therefore, it is definitely not sufficient for historical data analysis. Neither is Memorystore a SQL-based storage system. And ideally, we would love to have SQL for analysis. Again, it is incomplete for the lack of the option to figure out where the logs are coming from or to even capture them. Considering all of that, option B is not a good option. How about we use Stackdriver logging with a cloud storage sync? Now, Stackdriver is a central logging solution within GCP, and definitely a thumbs up for that, right? We would like to have a ready solution that we can just plug in and collect logs and do monitoring and have all the data available to us. So Stackdriver logging is definitely good. Cloud storage as a data sink, also useful, because it can scale to a large amount of storage. You also have different cost levels. If you're not going to use certain data for analysis, you can put them in some kind of cold storage and therefore get a lower cost. So for that also, this would be a reasonable option. However, it gets a thumbs down on being able to run analytics on the data. Given that it's just a blob storage, you've got all this data, and yes, you can run it, run queries on it, say via BigQuery. However, it is not going to be very efficient. So even though it might work, it is not a suitable choice for running analysis workloads. Given that, option D is out. Option C suggests that we use Stackdriver logging, but now with a BigQuery sync. We already saw that Stackdriver is a great option, right? It has a ready-made way in which we can collect metrics and logging and have them stored. For analysis, is BigQuery a good solution? Absolutely. BigQuery is an OLAP and it is very well suited for analysis across large amounts of data, historical data, using SQL queries. So this looks like a good option. But is there an easy way to move the data from Stackdriver logging to BigQuery sync? The answer is yes. With a couple of clicks, you can export data from the logs and have that be stored in BigQuery. So this works great. Not only that, BigQuery is very suitable for long-term storage. In fact, if you do not use the BigQuery table for 90 consecutive days, the storage automatically drops to become cost-effective, equivalent to what is offered by cloud storage nearline. We can also, of course, have data be archived. We can even delete tables that we're not going to be using anymore. And therefore, even for long-term storage, BigQuery is a great option. So in terms of connecting Stackdriver logging to BigQuery, very good. In terms of storage, very good. And we've got also the logs and metrics being captured by Stackdriver. Considering all of that, option C is our best option, which is to use Stackdriver logging with a BigQuery sync. If you're interested in picking up loads more learning on Google Cloud, go ahead and subscribe right away.